And I guess, you know, for someone like me who's trying to talk to their friends and encourage them to get the vaccine, and there's a lot of distrust out there and different information that people are hearing. Do you have any strategies or advice for encouraging those people to go and get vaccinated, particularly those who do not trust it?
Well, you know, it depends on what the reason for the vaccine hesitancy is. In your dealing with African Americans, there is this historical issue that just won't go away. And that is decades and decades ago, before most young African Americans were even born, there was the disgraceful Tuskegee situation where the federal government did a series of studies on syphilis and were egregiously unethical studies. Now, that gets passed from generation to generation. So you were not born during the Tuskegee, but I'm sure you heard about it from your grandfather and your father and your mother, no doubt. So what you've got to do is first respect the hesitancy that relates to that, because that's a good reason to be skeptical. But at the same time, to explain to people that since then, ethical constraints have put into place in the form of institutional review boards and data and safety monitoring boards that would make that type of unethical behavior completely impossible to happen. Once you establish that, then you go through the things that make them hesitant. They say, well, you know, you did it really quickly. It usually takes years to get a vaccine approved. How could you possibly get it approved in 11 months? Well, the reason is it's a reflection of the extraordinary scientific advances that were made over the previous 10 to 15 years. It's not compromising safety, and it's not compromising scientific integrity. Then the next question is, well, how do I know it's really safe and effective? Is this the federal government lying to us, or is it the pharmaceutical companies that just want to make a lot of money? Well, what you can then tell them that the determination of whether it's safe and effective is made by independent bodies of data and safety monitoring boards that have absolutely are beholden to no one except the general public, so that the decision is both transparent and both independent. So once you get that established, hopefully you'll win over some of your colleagues who are hesitant.